Well, you already know all the injuries and all the problems you have to find 11 players, so I won't waste any time on that. But I will use that to congratulate all the players who get the minutes, all the players who are coming into the field, fighting for each other, no matter who is starting, no matter who is playing as a sub or on the starting 11, they are just giving their life for each other. And before the game, I show them two things. The first one was the unbeaten record of Columbus Crew at home. The last time they lost was 7 October 2020. And they just published that today before the game. So when we saw that, for us was like a big motivation, coming here as an underdog and try to break that record. And the second thing I showed them was no player of DC United on the MLS All-Star game, which is painful because I believe there are many on our team who deserve to be there. And that maybe it's due to the fact that DC was not good enough the last couple of years, that maybe we lost a little bit the respect of the league and of the fans. And little by little, with this big heart and fighting spirit, we are coming back in those spots where DC United deserve to be. So I'm very glad for the guys because they deserve a lot more compliments than what they're getting right now. And we are a family, we are a team who is willing to die for each other on the field. So about the game, we came with a clear plan on pressing them on the right moments. We scored two out of our four goals by pressing moments on the right, with the right timing, with Jordi, with Kevin, and with Ola. They did it amazing. And then was kind of a medium low block and play on transition. And this team can do that. That first ball vertical with running players, and all the goals came like that. And the last remark is, we got a red card last weekend against Cincinnati because the player was going 1v1 with the goalkeeper. Now the explanation we get is that the ball was too far from Kevin's feet and he didn't have the chance to go 1v1, and that's why it's only a yellow card. Can someone in this room correct me if that's... Because that's not the case. Kevin was with the ball and Kevin was going to finish. So why is not a red card? I still can't believe. Maybe because there is a rule that they can't punish in the same action twice with a penalty and a red card at the same time. So I would like to have an explanation on that, because 3 days ago against Cincinnati, for us was very clear, it was a red card and not for them. Because otherwise it's nothing to 3 on the halftime, 11 against 10, and the game is over. And well, we still have players that are not able to play 90 minutes, like Jordi, like Kevin. We treat him like a king. Ola was coming back from a concussion protocol. Ola is the only number 9 that we have right now fit on the team. And we also wanted to keep him fit for that important game against Montreal. And at the end, we suffer. And this team knows how to suffer, knows how to stand up. I'm still a bit disappointed about the two goals we concede, because I always strive for perfection and I really want to keep the 0 and a clean sheet every single game. But due to the circumstances, we get 3 points, but now we lose another important player like Bill Amit, that probably will have a muscle injury. And it's another one on the list. But still, the positive mood and the energy of this team make me believe that we have a chance against every opponent, even when we are only with 11 players and nothing else. So congratulations to my team and the efforts they did. And when I say team, it's not only the players, it's the whole crew behind the team working in the shadows that make whatever it takes to help these players to be ready to play.
Thank you, Coach. We'll go into questions. We'll go to Steve Goff first.
Hernan, you did not put your cleats on. You were very disappointed.
Sorry, Steve. Can you repeat the question?
You did not put your cleats on, like you said you might do.
No, but there was space on the bench. We have two substitutions less. We were with 18 players, so it was possible. I was thinking about. I was running a couple of times, but it's I'm not fit enough. But what I'm gonna try to do is to run the half marathon in September in Washington. So I'm gonna start to prepare for that half marathon in September. Hopefully, there's no need to put my cleats on and be on the bench. Hopefully.
Very good. Life is about fitness, so this is a good thing.
Yeah, you told us like a couple of months ago that the survive of the fittest. So you know, and you can see now how important it is to be fit, because otherwise you can't fight in a midweek game the way the guys did it. And that's why for me it was so important to be fit, because we need to compensate a lot of other things that we don't have right now with energy and team spirit and fitness. So of course I understood your title at that moment with all the injuries we have. We still have many injuries, but believe me, it's not my fault. It's just the calendar is crazy. There are a lot of stuff going on with the international break, players coming back from the national team, and a lot going on. I'm still not training the way I would like to train. The amount of hours and the amount of sessions that I would like to give, hopefully it's coming later in the season or next season. But I'm very proud the way the guys are fighting on the field.
Yeah. So you have all these absences for this game, and then right at the beginning, you know, Bill gets hurt. You know, he's a leader of the team. He's a key player, being the goalkeeper. Was there some concern about how your team would react to another setback like that?
We had at this moment of the season, we are exact on the half of the season, and this team had so many obstacles and difficulties that make us stronger, since the facilities and the field where we train, that also make us stronger, because then we're coming to these beautiful stadiums and we enjoy how beautiful the grass is. All the injuries, missing players, important key players and leaders who are not on the field today. But anytime someone is missing, another player stands up to fulfill that gap. And that's why last week, I think I got a question from Claudia Pagan about how important it is of how we do as a staff to make sure that every time a new player is coming on the field, knows what to do, and it's ready to go. And that's about attention and a lot of communication. We speak and we talk to all of them, from number one until even the players that are right now with Loudon. We are always keeping in contact, because you never know when you're gonna need them. And today is the proof.
We'll go to Jason Anderson.
Hernan, thanks for speaking with us. Congrats. It seems like you're in a pretty excellent mood right now. I kind of wanted to ask about something pertaining to that. We got a shot of you after the second goal, the goal that the first goal for Jordy in the game. It looked like kind of a big moment for the team in terms of not just scoring a goal in that moment, but the quality of the goal, the move forward, breaking the lines. How did that stack up for you as far as the goals the team has managed to score this year?
I think today we were very efficient, but looking back to all the previous games, we create a lot of opportunities, and our expected goals and expected assists are much higher than what we score right now. So today was about efficiency, but also the way we score the goals, like you tell, on transition, pressing on the right moment and forcing the opponent making mistakes. That's great, but that's also something where we have been putting a lot of energy and hours since day one. It's about our style of play, and it's about of the players putting in practice all those principles the right way. And today was Jordi, and before was Roberta, and before was Paul Arriola, and before was Adrian Perez, and before was I don't know how many players having in the starting 11. And every week I need to change 3-4 players, which make it very difficult for our synchronization and automatics in the team, but still we manage in a certain way to get a good result. And we know how hard it's going to be this next period with a lot of games, in on the road. And these points, especially tonight and next Sunday, those are straight opponents in the fight of that very last spot on playoff. And when the season started, nobody believed that we could be where we are right now. It's half of the season. There's still a lot of points to go, a lot of games to go. So both feet on the ground, keep on working hard, because a lot can happen.
But Mauricio Gomez. Mauricio.
Felicidades, profe. En esta victoria se le nota la felicidad tanto en la cara como en su actitud. En unas entrevistas pasadas dijo que no habían los jugadores claves y que iba a utilizar el plan A, B, C, D, y creo que todos esos planes han funcionado. Esta victoria refleja que no importan los jugadores, sino el esfuerzo que el profe como director está poniendo al equipo. También, por otro lado, vemos que Paul Arriola y Donovan Pines, jugadores del equipo, son campeones del Gold Cup. Entonces, en sí, él está creciendo. Simplemente quería felicitarlo por eso y de, a ver qué nos podría comentar usted del juego, ya que lo dijo en inglés, si no lo puede decir en español. Gracias.
Cómo no. Muchas gracias por sus amables palabras. Yo no me quiero llevar ningún crédito en todos los puntos y las actuaciones. Es todos los jugadores, 100%. Son los jugadores los que entran al campo, son los jugadores los que entrenan y se matan durante la semana, son los jugadores los que entienden qué es lo que hay que hacer, depende del rival. Son los jugadores los que están llevando a cabo este nuevo sistema de juego que en tan poco tiempo nos ha dado tantas satisfacciones. Así que todos los créditos, 100% de los créditos, por favor, dáselos a los jugadores. Y con respecto al partido de hoy, explicar en español que la intención del partido fue la de presionar en los momentos justos, la de jugar en un bloque medio para salir muy rápido de contragolpe, para generar situaciones de gol en transición con la velocidad de Kevin y de Jordi, con el olfato goleador de Ola Camara, que ya tiene 9 goles, y con el esfuerzo colectivo. Este equipo se basa en los esfuerzos colectivos. No tenemos ningún superhéroe que individualmente nos va a ganar el partido. Este es un equipo que necesita de todos, absolutamente todos, para luchar, para apoyarse, para pelear por cada pelota como si fuera la última. Y esa es la manera en la que estamos consiguiendo los puntos. Y muy orgulloso. Así que 100% de crédito para los jugadores, de los cuales estoy muy orgulloso y los quiero mucho. Mis jugadores son mi familia. Estoy acá solo en DC, extrañando a mi hermano, a mi mamá, a mi papá, haciendo un esfuerzo grande e intentando adaptarme a una nueva cultura, a una nueva, a un nuevo estilo de vida, a una nueva competición. Y lo estoy dejando todo por mis jugadores, que es mi familia en este momento. Así que muy orgulloso de ellos.
One more question, coach. Mario Maya, go ahead.
Hola, Hernán. Felicitaciones en los 3 puntos. Solo quería preguntar, ¿cómo crees que fue el desempeño del equipo, especialmente en el primer tiempo, donde lograron presionar a la defensa de Columbus en 2 de los 3 goles?
Bueno, fantástico. El plan fue excelente. Estoy muy contento de ver que convertimos los goles de la manera en la que lo planeamos, de la manera en la que entrenamos, y los chicos lo están llevando a cabo de manera fenomenal. Así que me llena de orgullo ver que algo que se pudo prever, algo que se pudo planificar con imágenes, con mucho esfuerzo, con mucho sacrificio, los chicos lo están llevando a cabo de manera increíble. Así que me llena de orgullo ver que uno le da herramientas, uno le da ideas para desarrollar, y los jugadores lo están haciendo. Así que muy, muy feliz por todos, por Jordi en especial, que hoy convierte 2 goles. Sé lo mucho que tuvo que luchar para estar en forma, para evitar lesiones. Así que un jugador más que nosotros hemos recuperado junto con todo el equipo médico, con el equipo técnico. Y Sabíamos que Jordi en algún momento nos iba a dar alegrías. Así que muy buen partido de Jordi en Cincinnati, muy buen partido de Jordi hoy. Y ahora a recuperar fuerzas, porque el domingo queremos ir otra vez por los 3 puntos.